Trump! We love Trump! Few predicted that would be the name Republicans shouted at their convention.
Donald J. Trump is truly an instrument of hope.
His has been a virtually unprecedented path to the Republican presidential nomination. He was born to a life of privilege in this New York suburb. Receiving an economics degree from a prestigious business school, he turned his sights on Manhattan and the family business, developing real estate. With his father's help and money, he launched into big-name projects that always carried his name in big gold letters. His biographers describe an insecure man who lived for, who craved attention. And he got it. For his affairs and two divorces, fortunes lost and found again. Local journalists say they would often get calls from someone describing himself as a Trump spokesman, boasting about his conquests. He sounded a lot like Trump himself.
He's somebody that has a lot of options, and frankly, he gets called by everybody. He gets called by everybody in the book in terms of women.
The man who sells himself as a successful businessman has had his share of financial difficulties, 4 company bankruptcies, more than average in the U.S. Still, his reputation landed him a popular reality television show where people competed to work for him.
You're fine.
His supporters say they'd like that he's a self-described billionaire and that he's brash.
He speaks from the heart. He's not a politician.
He's broken all the long-held rules of politics, insulting women, Native Americans, Mexicans, Muslims, even a disabled man.
I don't know what I said.
But nothing has stopped him from reaching this stage, even though he's made few concrete campaign promises.
I am going to be the greatest jobs president that God ever created.
Remember his agenda that. Includes imposing harsh tariffs on Chinese goods, renegotiating the free trade agreement with Mexico and Canada. Michael D'Antonio, who wrote a biography on Trump, doesn't think he'll follow through on all of his promises, but he says he is concerned by the way Trump thinks.
He truly believes that by definition, Donald Trump is the better person for almost any job. So if Donald Trump wants to be president, he assumes that that would be the best thing for the country, that no one else is better, and that whatever he does in pursuit of that goal is justified. It's a bizarre way of looking at the world. It's almost as if he were a king.
Trump became popular with the Republican base when he led the so-called birther movement, leading the argument that President Barack Obama shouldn't be president because he wasn't born in the United States.
If we get distracted by sideshows and carnival barkers.
The president would later lambast Trump for it at the White House Correspondents' Dinner in 2011.
Say what you will about Mr. Trump, he certainly would bring some change to the White House. Let's see what we've got up there.
That night, the political and media elite loudly laughed at him.
We want Trump now!
The people who have studied Trump say he is likely focused on the fact they aren't laughing now. Patty Culhane, Al Jazeera, Washington.